It all started with a single, low-quality photograph of a burger. And from that one image, I managed to generate 4 additional shots from different angles. Then, using a secret workflow, I was able to create an unlimited number of poster designs in just a few minutes. I also applied the same workflow on packaging, and I got these amazing results. All this was made using a single tool called Lovart. Lovart is the world's first AI design agent. They're still in beta, and I was invited as an early tester to explore its full potential. I've added a few invite codes for you in the description below, so make sure to grab yours if you want to try it. Now, let's dive right into today's video. To create unlimited poster designs, I'm going to follow these 3 steps. First, I'll generate different angles of the product image. Second, I will use a base prompt to set up the poster's layout. And third, I'll use an action prompt to start producing endless variations. Let's start by uploading a product image. I'll use this low-resolution burger photo. What I want now is different shots of this burger from different angles. For that, the best AI model for this task is called Flux Context. It's excellent at preserving image detail better than any other model right now. So here, I'll ask Lovart to use Flux Context to generate a bottom-up view of the attached burger image. Here's how Lovart handles the task. It starts thinking, reads the input image, and creates a step-by-step plan to make it happen. But while the image is being generated, let me give you a quick tour of Lovart's interface. Over here, we've got the Tools panel, and this is the chat box, and this is the canvas. And for the prompt box, we can attach images from here. Use a specific style from the style library, get internet research, and access these top-tier AI models for images, videos, and even 3D. Right now, it is still working on the task using Flux Context as requested. And here we have it, the requested angle with all the details from the input image perfectly preserved. Now let's request a top view angle. Just wait a few seconds. And here we go again, a perfect top view angle matching the exact texture of the original image. To save your time, let me give you a single prompt to produce multiple angles at once. So this multitask prompt can generate the same current angle, a bottom-up view angle, a top-down view angle, and finally, a top view angle. Once you submit the prompt along with your image, you will get 4 angles at once like that. This multitasking ability is incredibly useful. Just write a multi-step prompt and let Lovart do it in one go. So right here, I submitted this first image along with a base prompt. This prompt generates a high-quality poster design. It works as the base for creating new variations. You can get this prompt for free from the video description below. After submitting your base prompt, you will get it executed like that. We have the exact same burger angle implemented into a good quality poster. After that, I submitted the action prompt to start automating the process. So here, I'm asking for a burger wearing a pirate hat, and I also changed all poster's details except the footer. And I got this amazing pirate-themed burger poster. Notice how the sticker, call to action, and header are all completely updated as requested. After that, I asked for a burger inside a secret chamber. Simple as that. Look how beautiful the result is. Can you believe this came from just a single line of text? Just look at the details. Everything is nearly perfect. And the best part, all of this text can be edited with a super simple trick. Just keep watching to see how it's done later. Here, I asked for another one over a chalkboard background, and I got this beautiful one. So right now, I made these 4 posters from this first angle, and I can keep creating if I want. And for the second angle, I added it to the chat and asked for a vintage-style poster. I also asked to change the CTA text to order now. And here's what I got. After that, I asked for a futuristic version, a Minecraft-style version, and finally, an outdoor street version. And for the bottom-up view angle, I was a bit descriptive, and I got outstanding results. So here, I asked for a flying burger on a city street with a concrete sign hanging from the top using 2 chains. I also requested to change the sticker text to 100% natural. and I got this amazing result. Just check out the detail in the header, the burger, the CTA placement, and the sticker. Next, I asked for a POV-style poster of a man holding the burger in front of a food truck, and I got this one, with the header text placed right on the truck body, just as requested. The next one, I asked for something more dynamic, a giant burger falling from a plane, with Earth in the background and a motion and action vibe, and I got this outstanding result. I really like the header idea and the motion in this one. Finally, I asked to change the footer to these two lines, and then make another POV poster of an escape scene inside a storm. The initial result was good, but the header was a bit basic, and the footer had two different font sizes, so I clarified my instructions, asking for the same font size in the footer, a stronger storm, and a more dynamic header. And I got them all, but the footer text was too large, so I clearly added my instructions again, and I finally got what I wanted. A great-looking POV poster with a cool header and two lines of small text in the footer. Finally, let's find out what I did for this last angle. For this one, I asked for 5 posters in a single prompt, and here is what I got. So now, using just this one image, I was able to create these 20 posters from different angles in almost 1 hour. Next, let's animate one of these posters. I attached this image to the chat and asked Lovart to animate it using Kling. I described exactly how I wanted the animation to flow, along with a voiceover in the background reading the poster header. So here, Lovart started by creating the background music, then generated the voiceover. After that, created the animation. And finally, merged everything into a final video.
Mighty Burger.
The first animation was great, but the burger moved out of the frame, so I updated the prompt to keep it there. The second version was also awesome, but there was an unwanted flash on the burger. So I asked for 2 more versions, pointing out the flashing issue. The first new version was pretty cool, with a subtle animation and a nice glowing effect. And here is the second version. It was perfect. It had everything I wanted, looking clean and cinematic. So this is how you create an unlimited number of posters in Lovart, and also animate your output results like that. Now, let me show you how to edit your output images. All right, let's say you want to change the text in the header, but you really like the design and don't want to change it. That's where the Inpainting feature comes in. Simply select Inpaint, paint over the text you want to replace, and type in your new text, just like that. Then click on Inpaint and wait a few seconds. The text will be updated to exactly what I asked for, using the same font size and styling. Now let me show you Outpaint. We can use it to convert our poster into a social media post. I just select a 1-to-1 aspect ratio, then click Outpaint, and Lovart will handle the rest. And here we go. Now let's move on to the unlimited packaging workflow. In this step, I won't push you to use complex-based prompts. I just described a kid's potato chip bag in simple terms and submitted it. After that, Lovart created a plan and designed the bag. And after building its knowledge and crafting the prompt, it used it to produce this design. The initial design was cool, but I thought the illustration could be more detailed. So for the second step, I requested 4 more variations with more detailed illustrations, and this can be considered the action prompt. Again, after the same process, I got these 4 designs. I was honestly impressed with the results. Each one had a unique design and concept. Let's try this again together. I simply want to use the 4th design's layout to produce 4 new specific flavors like that. I will simply write what I want and then hit submit. And after a few minutes, let's see what we'll get. Another 4 cool designs, all using the same style and layout as requested. Some of them had minor text issues, but I could easily fix that with the Inpainting as mentioned before. Inpainting will simply fix the text using the exact same style like that. And here we go. Let's extract a flat design from this bag mockup. just click the image generator icon and change the model to ChatGPT image, then use image reference to attach the design you want to extract. Just select the image you want to extract the design from, and then write something like that. Generate an identical illustration design without the bag mockup. Change the aspect ratio to 2:3 and quality to high, then click generate. After a few seconds, I will get an identical flat design like that. To be honest, this trick is a game changer. You can take this flat design, enhance it, trace it, and do whatever you want. It will simply save you tons of time. And here are another two bags I turned into flat designs and ended up getting almost identical results. I can attach this barbecue design and request more variations of it and do that again and again. And here, Lovart will start thinking, building knowledge, making a plan, and generating the images. And here are another four barbecue designs as requested. Now let's move on to the final part. So here I started by asking for a burger restaurant logo. Then Lovart asked me back about the name and type of that restaurant. After I answered, it searched for inspiration and delivered these four concepts. But I preferred to describe what I want right here. And I got these four versions, and I ended up choosing this one. So I asked for a cleaner version with solid colors and no textures. Lovart here used ChatGPT, and that changed the logo text a bit like that. So I asked to use Flux Context to maintain consistency, and I got this version with the original logo shape intact. Then I finally asked for black sesame seeds on the top bun, and the final version came out clean and professional. And here is a quick comparison between the textured and clean versions. And here is another example. I followed the previous steps, and I ended up getting this logo. After that, I asked for a branding identity, and I got those branding concepts. After that, I asked for more, and I got those, and also those. I even requested a style guide. After making a plan, I was really shocked. Lovart created an HTML-based brand guide that was surprisingly well-structured. Lastly, I asked for point-of-sale materials. Here's what I got. A menu. A counter display. A table tent. And finally, a loyalty card. That's it for today. If you're interested in trying Lovart, you'll find all the details in the video description below. Thanks for watching.